Wilkins, if I were only 30 years younger.
I would like to go too, but the North is for the youth, Doctor.
Theory. Third. Mm-hmm. Rasmussen. And Wegener.
Poor Wegener.
There never was a braver man.
It would make him happy if he could only know that Lawrence is following his footsteps.
Maybe he does know.
Maybe he does.
Dr. Wegener left us his theories of the inland ice. He lost his life on the expedition that was to convert those theories into facts. That is a tragedy from which science has suffered. We are setting forth in an effort to carry on his great work with the aid of Dr. Brandt, whose knowledge of the Arctic is second to no one. Dr. Matuszek, whose contributions to science are known to you all. And my young friend, Fritz Kermel. I have every reason to hope for success. But there's one more. A friend of science whose generous contributions have made this expedition financially possible. Knowing full well the hardships and dangers he may be called upon to face, but from experience, knowing nothing of how to face them, he is coming with us as one of us, with the courage of the true adventurer. I speak of our new friend, John Drake.
Dr. Lawrence, you referred to generosity and courage. Generosity is an easy virtue if one happens to have a lot of money. As for courage, it's relative. I myself am afraid of aeroplanes, but I can imagine no one being afraid of flying with Mrs. Lawrence. I love the outdoors, and snow is snow, whether it be in Switzerland or on the Rings Glacier. So, joining an expedition led by Dr. Lawrence becomes a pleasure rather than a peril.
As president of the International Society for Arctic Research, I give you the Lawrence Expedition.
It can be done, even this late. Look. Overland to the fjord, then across the ice to here. Then it's a...
Then to here.
Exactly.
Rinks Glacier.
Well, why not?
That's where Wegener got his. At just this time last year.
That's what I meant.
Yellow?
Say, Lawrence.
Hello, Dragon.
Look here, old man.
Of course, I only work here, but I...
You do what?
Well, anyway, I am here.
And you're bored. Yes, I was afraid of that.
What's all this about whether we stay or go on?
Listen, Dragon. It's taken us 8 weeks longer than we planned to get to this point. Brand has an idea it's dangerous to go on to the rink scraper.
But he...
I know it's time for the ice to break up. But if we don't go now, it means waiting until winter, and... I just don't feel like waiting, that's all.
Rink scraper. Wasn't that where Dr. Wagner...
Exactly. But don't you worry, old boy. I'm not asking you to go. I'm not asking anyone to go. Forget it and enjoy yourself.
Takuyuk, Inuk, Adazik, Namik.
What you say?
Poor Carl. Hello?
And no sign of Lawrence?
Poor chap. Well, might as well go now.
Yeah. We'll go.
The big sled and the small one for radio.
Kuya Nexawak.
Ikki Kyo. Say!
Poor Lawrence.
Well, no one can say you didn't want it. Home is almost due south of me, isn't it?
Yeah, south.
How long will it take? Well, we're going, aren't we?
Yeah. North. It took the Eskimo 4 days to get here. It'll probably take us five to get there.
At least.
Do I understand that you're going after Lawrence? You've all lost your minds.
Don't misunderstand. If I thought there was any chance of saving Lawrence, I'd be with you to the end. But the man's dead. Well, how long could a man live in this country without food, without anything?
Depends on the man. Lawrence could live a long, long time.
Well, why not send the Eskimo?
They won't go. It's too dangerous.
The ice is breaking up.
And we're going to risk our lives looking for a corpse.
That's how it is, Dragon. That's how it is.
Thank you. At least the instruments are safe.
Instruments? What about the food? We can't eat instruments.
Snow is snow, Dragon.
Take a look, Dragon. It's worth it. Across the fjord, Wegener's route. Poor devil.
Poor devil? After he crossed the fjord, he'll have food. Plenty of food, while we're starving.
After he crosses the fjord.
Dragon, you don't seem to get the idea.
This is not Switzerland.
But look here. Listen, Dragon. When Lawrence stepped on that ice, each step was loaded with dynamite. Those bergs roll over and drown a man in ice water. They can crack wide open and embalm him in tons of ice. It isn't easy, Dragon.
Thank you.
to witness something few white men have ever seen. The birth of an iceberg. Take 3 weeks. Without food, we would starve.
What are we going to do?
Follow Lawrence. Drifting fast. We'll never make the other side. We'd better try to get to that big berg ahead.
We'll pitch camp here.
But now to go on to the village?
This is the end of the trail.
We're drifting.
Yes. Straight to the open sea.
Well, this looks like a nice, comfortable iceberg anyway.
Yellow.
You said when we were ready to drop.
Yes. I told Fritz to open the last can.
After this, what?
A seal or a polar bear, if we're lucky.
Huh. Without guns.
Come on. I'll calculate our position, figuring the drift.
Now, if only...
This. Oh, this. This. Oh, this.
At first, I got their call signal. Then it faded completely. Their batteries are dead.
You talk, or where you die. You're driving me mad, isn't it? Staring.
Thank you.
No, Kimmel.
Hang on, old man. Hang on.
Tough going, old boy.
The end.
fool! A fool! 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 Fool!
Yawn. What do you figure our position at present?
At 5 o'clock in the morning, we'll be nearer land than we'll ever be again. 4 miles. Too bad we have no boat. Thank you.
understand. What's he trying to do?
He's making for the Eskimo village. 4 miles away. That's what he's trying to do.
It's dangerous. Something's happened, or we would have heard from her by now.
Mm-hmm.
She was to have crossed Rink's Glacier. Yes? I'll follow the same course.
Help. Thank you. is that look?
Airplane. Iceberg.
Give me that clock. I up, puck. Kayak. Namaste. Kayak. Iceberg. Kayak. Asun. Asun. Iceberg.
Give me that look, somebody. Iluliak, somebody.
Touché. Dragon. Wherever they are, I hope they know that they have not died in vain.